Probably the most difficult thing I've ever done is ascend Mount Everest. And it might come as a surprise. It's very hard to get to become an astronaut and train for a mission and go fly a mission, but the psychological difference of being on Mount Everest is pretty substantial. When you're in space, you're inside your spacecraft, you're comfortable, you're in shirt sleeves, it's warm, you have 3 square meals a day, you're not hypoxic, you're not malnourished. Up on Mount Everest, every second of every day, you're feeling the thinning air. You can't get enough calories in your body. You need 5 or 6 thousand calories a day just to break even. And so you feel the life threat every minute of every day. There are avalanches that come calving down off of the walls around the cirque of Everest Base Camp. And so you feel that cumulative psychological stress of, you know, you're in a really dangerous place. On a space shuttle mission, in contrast, you feel the threat, obviously, on the launch. You know, you've got 7 million pounds of thrust, you know, taking you off of the planet. But then it's very beautiful and peaceful. You're in this extraordinary glass-bottomed boat looking at your home planet. And you feel like you're the luckiest person alive. And so the only other time that you feel perhaps some degree of trepidation is floating outside that hatch and going out in the vacuum of space on a spacewalk. For the most part, being in space is just a peaceful, relaxing, disarming kind of a place. Whereas the mental toll and the physical toll of Everest is pretty exceptional. Certainly on Everest, you're out there more or less on your own. You have a small team, a cadre of folks that you're with, and I had the good fortune to be with about 20 climbers on my team, and my sidekick was Dinuru Sherpa from Fort Say, just one of the most amazing athletes and mountaineers in the world. He's now summited Mount Everest 16 times. I used to joke him all the time that he had 3 lungs and 2 hearts because he could just kind of run up most parts of Everest. Summit day, however, was a great equalizer. He was very much suffering just as much as I was, but you're pretty much left to your own resources. No one can carry you down from summit day on Mount Everest. You're going to do it under your own power, or you'll add to the 250 souls that are left on the side of the mountain. So it's pretty sobering, and you've got to have your wits about you. I think that also weighs heavily in terms of the psyche of being high in the mountains versus being in space, where you have this brilliant team of engineers and flight controllers in Houston and around the world, kind of looking over your shoulder, and if things start to go south, you've got the A-team at your back.